Hello, everybody. Andrea here with Dental L. So I have been a dental professional for about 17 years. I have had my own mobile dental hygiene practice for about 3 years now. I had to think about that for a second, about 3 years now. So what I found when I first started my own practice was I was overwhelmed. There's so much to do. There's so much to set up when it comes to insurance companies, electronic transferring, direct deposits. You need an office number, even as a mobile dental hygienist, where I was going into patients' homes at the time. You need an office number. I was seeing patients in my own home too. So I needed insurance, all kinds of things to have to worry about. So if you have your own dental hygiene practice or you're thinking about starting one, I do have a course now that is a new course where I offer help specific for insurances. So how you basically submit to insurance companies, I go through all of the different companies here in Ontario, to be specific. I go through the different codes to submit, what the codes are, depending on the fee guide for that year. I go through with you which codes are quite often denied. I go through which ones you should be putting through for new patient exams, for dental hygiene exams, for perio, for if you're just doing a scaling, if you're seeing children, adults. So I have been doing this for 3 years, but I was also working in dental offices where I dealt with insurance companies. So I kind of know the ins and outs. I teach you guys what to do if a claim is denied. Like, how the heck did that happen? I talk about how to talk to patients about putting the onus on them. So you as the provider aren't on the phone on hold for hours every day talking to their insurance companies. They should do some of the work for you. A little secret is I do not ask the insurance companies what is covered. I leave that up to the patient. If they don't want to do that, then what I do, and I do explain this inside the course, is I put everything through and I just let the patients know what's covered and what's not covered. Because once you put everything through, most insurance companies will give you a breakdown. They might say 0%, they might say 80%, they might say 100%, depending on the coverage. So I go through all of that inside the course. Also, I go through what to do if patients have primary insurance and secondary insurance. If both of those insurance companies are the same company, or if they're different, when can you send electronically, how to set that up? Also, when do you have to mail in the form and when do you have to email the forms? Are you guys overwhelmed yet? I know I was when I first started, but now I feel like an old pro because now I've been doing this for several years. I can do it with my eyes closed, but I got a lot of help from other hygienists at first. I had tons of questions, but I felt bad asking so many questions. So what I wanted to do was to develop a course to help new dental hygiene practice owners, how to navigate through all of that, how to go through step one, step two, step three on setting everything up. I go through if you have a dental software or not, then you might have to do everything by hand on paper if you don't have a software yet. That's okay. You do not have to send EDI electronically. That's what EDI means, electronically. So you might have to do everything by paper, but you have to print out certain forms in order to do that. So I help you guys with that too, because I did that when I first started my practice, is I did everything on paper. But if you send the wrong form, if you have the patient sign in the wrong spot, it gets denied and then you have to send it again. More importantly, you don't get paid. So I teach you guys how to do it properly, what codes to submit. I go through every single insurance for Ontario, what you have to do to submit. Took me a lot of time to make this course, but I love it. And I'm so happy to do it because I remember how overwhelmed I felt when I first started. So I want to take the overwhelm out for you, for dental hygienists who need the extra help. I do also have another course called the Mobile RDH Academy if you want to start your own mobile dental hygiene business. So I do offer two different courses. The insurance course, which I will leave the link for you guys down below, just talks about insurance. There's a lot to know, as I said, how to set everything up, all of that. I'll leave the link for you guys down below. there's any questions, just comment. The other course that I do have, Mobile RDH Academy, teaches you how to set up your own mobile dental hygiene practice, what you have to buy, the types of expenses, things you might want to purchase right away, things you can save your money on. I talk about buying a sterilizer. Do you need one? Can you use one at another office? What did I do when I first started my mobile dental hygiene practice? What mistakes I made, what I learned, and what I'm doing now 3 years later. So that is also a fantastic course. I am here to help dental hygienists start their own practice. So make sure, if you're thinking about starting your own dental hygiene practice, make sure to contact your local dental hygiene association, depending on where you work. You cannot have your own dental hygiene practice everywhere. There's fine print here in Ontario. Yes, we can. But there's fine print with that. You have to be working for a certain amount of years. There might be a course to take. Please contact your dental hygiene association to ask those questions. If you already have your business, good for you. I can help you. So I will leave the links for you guys down below for those courses. If you have any questions, please let me know. And I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Please click like if you haven't already, and make sure to hit the subscribe button, because that does help me and my channel. Thank you guys so much. Have a great night, and we will talk soon.